Hey everybody, Jason here from MyAnimate. Hope you're all doing fantastic this week. So in this week's snippet, I'm going to give you some tools on how to streamline your facial animation and lip sync. So when I'm doing lip sync, one of the hardest parts about lip sync is figuring out what shapes to use, what shapes to favor, which ones to sort of slur together, and which ones to help enunciate the words a little bit better, like so popping vowels and all that kind of stuff. And usually when I start lip sync, I'll think about the emotion first, right? Because that dictates the shapes that you're going to use. So if you're going to do smile shapes, it's going to be sort of like this, right? And we don't want to mix smiles with frowns in the same emotion. Okay, so when I'm actually going to approach my lip sync for my shot, what I usually do is take a camera, and just like I was shooting for acting choices and mechanics, I then shoot just straight on like this, so I can just see what happens naturally with the mouth, right? So I try to learn the line of dialogue first. Right, try to get like the enunciation correct, the emotions correct. And even if it's not perfect, it still gets me a lot closer to getting the lip sync to feel more natural. And then I can push it, I can caricature it from there, right? So this is one of these shots that we've got from MyAnimate here. And I wanted to do the lip sync for this particular shot here, right? So, and it's not like a far away shot or anything like that, but it's sort of like a medium close up, right? But I wanted to get the lip sync to feel as natural as possible. Okay. So even though I don't look like this character, at least I can then get like the lip sync a little bit closer so that I can push it from there and make it a little bit more animated, right? So what I usually do is shoot myself, you know, close up, you know, with the camera, digital camera, and then I bring it into Flipbook, and then I sync it up to my audio file here, right? So let's see. So right here.
Oh, just for fun.
Yeah, for kicks.
Yeah, it's so much fun studying organic chemistry. Are you mad?
Right. So you can see, like, I'm just mouthing, like I'm listening to the audio and I'm mouthing out what I want her to say in the way that I want her to say it. So in the very, very beginning here. I'm trying to play the corners a little bit more neutral, not mad, not angry, you know, but a little bit more just straight across, right? Oh, just for fun. You know, not impressed, right?
For fun.
And then going into a little bit of an asymmetrical smirk here, okay? And then...
For kicks.
And then here we can see, like, I'm preparing for this, right? So it's not just going from a closed mouth to yeah. It's like open and then yeah.
Yeah.
Right. So in there, I can really see and anticipate the loud pop sound, right? And then seeing how many frames it actually takes to get to that point, right? So it's like you get one favor right there, slow out of that shape, and then pop, boom. And then we follow through here a little bit more, right? So it doesn't just pop and rebound very quickly. It sort of goes a little bit beyond that and sort of softens that shape, but stays in that shape, right?
Yeah, it's
here again. So right, so going from here to here over one frame, right? So we're starting to favor out of that change in direction. That shape slows out of that shape and then pop, right? And then again, follow through, right? And then I'm basically going into a oh ooh, right? So it goes into the W shape there. So the O and then into W shape and then right into the M, like pop, boom, one frame up to there. But then it's only in there for one frame, right? And then here for the F, like coming up for the F, seeing like the top lip kind of pulled out this way and the bottom lip underneath the teeth. And then you get that fun, like just over one frame, boom. So it's a great way to study like the shapes and see how many frames it takes to drive that shape, you know, to drive that sound. And then organic chemistry. So it's not organic stop chemistry, it's organic chemistry. So that the C and the CH almost sort of blur together, right? And then chemistry, are you mad? So it's not chemistry stop, are you mad? It's chemistry, are you mad, right? And then this compression right here, so we get the closed M And then we compress, right? And then this is weird because it's almost like the motion blur is anticipating me moving down, right? Which is crazy, right? Like it's almost saying like, oh yeah, my mouth is actually moving quite fast right there, but it's still staying compressed. So I'm moving it sort of downwards, right? But my lips are staying compressed. So I definitely want to save that. So that'll be like over one frame, right? So keep them closed, keep them mad, right? And then we might have one frame, like one frame here of starting to come into the A shape and then really broadly getting into this shape. Right? So now when I go to apply this, I save this out as PNGs, right? And then I bring it into Maya because it's already synced to the audio file that we're going to be animating to. And then we've got it right here, like as our image plane. And then I can go in here and say, okay, yeah, maybe I'll have it just start to bring in that little smirk right here, that little bit of a corner coming up here. Like to get into this kind of asymmetrical shape. And the same thing here, opening up the mouth. So I opened up like a tiny bit sooner. And then I'm hearing sort of like almost like a lispy kind of, yeah. You know, the way she says it, right? So I'm bringing the tongue up for there. And then nice and broad, right? So I can see the shape that I'm making, but I want to make her more appealing. I want to make her, you know, get a nice line of action through the face, through the mouth, get this corner up a little bit more, just so it feels a little bit more connected, you know, and it's not so straight down, you know, straight down like our face would be. All right, pause in there. And then bringing these up, like, so you get these nice little dimpled cheeks, right? And then I'm actually bringing in the low teeth here, like, so it can kind of see the, for the it's, right? Now, usually, like, if you're just saying it's your tongue, right? But, like, for an animated character, it's almost nicer and it's more readable to actually see the lower teeth, like, come in here. It's, you know, if I'm really enunciating it, like I want to see those teeth right there. Now, when I'm shooting this, like it's a slight up angle. So I'm just trying to get like a straight on, but you know, if I just pull this lip down slightly, you'll probably see my low teeth right there. Right. And then same thing here. Right. So I'm starting to favor out of that shape and then pop boop, into the O shape. So I'm just starting to get that and then follow through with it, like to get into the O, the W shape. So, and then we get that one frame of the M, right? So what I'm trying to do here is this neck shape here is close to that M shape, right? So much, right? So I didn't want to keep, like, if I kept this same shape here, one frame after the one frame of M, the persistence of vision would just have a pop. Right. So I want to make sure that I'm favoring sort of like that closed mouth shape on the next frame. Right. So it's close to that shape and then I can pop it open. Right. Then we get the F, little compression, and then straight out into our F and then follow through. Right. So get a little bit bigger shape right there. Now in here, in the live action, I couldn't exactly say, I don't know how, like she says it so quickly, but organic chemistry. And I kept going organic, I don't know why, but I at least I can hear the sound and I can just say, okay, well, I'm just gonna put an N shape in here rather than an M shape, right? So I know like I made a mistake here, so I'm not gonna make that mistake in the animation, right? And in here, are you? Right, so making more of an O shape in here. And then into our M, compress, and then open up. So what I'm seeing here in the live action reference and what I'm hearing in the animation is I want to make sure that my shapes are preceding the sound a little bit. So it feels like she's making the shape and then you hear the sound. So it slightly precedes the actual audio. So it doesn't feel like... it doesn't feel delayed. So it's better to be early than to be late, like with your shapes, right? So I usually go one or two frames earlier to the actual sound. So if I'm scrubbing through here, are you mad? Like I'm opening up here a little bit earlier than the actual audio. But then when you see it like in real time, then it feels right. So this is it in real time, right?
Oh, just for fun.
Yeah, for kicks.
Yeah, it's so much fun studying organic chemistry. Are you mad?
Right?
Oh,
so,
just for
so when I'm actually looking at this, I can, another tip that I'm going to give you guys is I usually go into the AV controls in QuickTime and then play it back at half speed. Start.
Oh, just for fun.
Yeah, for kicks.
Yeah, it's so much fun studying organic chemistry. Are you mad?